Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsachanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhusya Sakhatvameva Tvameva Vidya Dravinam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Amadeva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Gurudeva Deva. Hari Om. We are now doing the 15th chapter, and where the Ashtavakra says, Ashtavakra informing to Janaka Maharaj, teaching all of us why we say we understand Vedanta but we are not able to realize it. That's primarily because we are not prepared the mind sufficiently pure for abiding in the knowledge. It's like a tenth man story where everyone is searching for the tenth man and missing their own counting. Everyone, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And where is the tenth man? And everybody taking their turns and counting everybody else, forgetting to count themselves, the tenth person. So everyone is looking for the tenth person. Then one who is looking for tenth person is the tenth person. So one, I am looking for what? I am looking for happiness, and I am looking for happiness all over the world. That's why the whole rat race is, I want that for me to be happy, I want this to be happy, I want that. So I am searching for happiness in the form of objects, thinking that those objects bring happiness. So when the objects come that I want, I am happy, all right. But again, the mind is still unsatisfied or not fully satisfied or temporarily satisfied, because it still wants some more for to be happy. If I didn't have much money, then I thought I'll be very happy. If I have some thousands of dollars for my rupees for my to build a house and so on. So when I got it, then I need more money to maintain those, as well as even to live more happily. So I want millions of dollars or millions of rupees or lakh year. Once I become lakh year, I find everybody is lakh year. So I want some more. So you will see some of the politicians have crores of money, but still they want some more. That means that wealth will never satisfy, even though I need wealth for my safety and security, but I am concerned about the security of the wealth one side, and I want to be more secure only by acquiring more and more and more and more. You can see people are trying to make more and more in spite of billions of rupees they have. That's because you will never get satisfied with any amount of money that you have. That's why in the Taittiriya Upanishad, there is an Ananda scale where the happiest person in the world is the one who owns the whole world, not just one country, whole world itself, and young enough to digest whatever he eats. That's another problem. You may have everything, but you cannot eat. And young enough to digest and enjoy all that. That happiness is called one unit of happiness, one unit of a human being happiness. And there is the 100 times more is one Gandharva happiness, 100 times more is Deva Gandharvas, and then Deva all the way, everyone is 100 times more than the previous guy, and like that all the way around 26 steps are there until you reach a Brahmaji, and his happiness is 10 to the power of 26 times that of one unit of that Ananda. But he's still not happy because he still wants some more, and that's called the infinite happiness he wants, and he can only get by getting infinite. But you cannot get infinite by finite means, and you cannot stop trying to become infinite. Only way is to recognize that I am already infinite. That is the whole teaching here. It says, how do I recognize? Until I turn myself inward and inquire, who am I? Who is the one who is searching for happiness? Validity of the seeker has to be established before any thought can be validated. And that's exactly what inquiry of who am I? How do I inquire who am I? Not sitting one place and say, who am I? Nothing will happen. You have to say, to know who you are, go to the scriptures And for that, you have to learn Vedanta, where Vedanta teaches you indirectly what's your nature, absolute, what's the nature of the world, what's your relationship with the world, and why you are by itself infinite, which means the world is only upper end. You are a adhara, adhisthanam for the universe also. And that has to be recognized. And for that, purity of the mind is essential. And that's what is the Shraddha is required, faith in the. So, I have faith in the Lord. So, no, a lot of people don't have really faith in the world. They think they have faith in the world. Why? Because when they say, oh Lord, take care of me, he says, if you surrender, I'll take care of you. So, but still they have doubts. Because the next day again they are asking. So, he says, Arati, Tana, Mana, Dhanu, Sabha, Kuch, Tera, Hai. So, Tana, Mana, Dhanu, Sabha, Kuch. Tana means the body, the mind, the money, everything is yours. That's what he offered in the Arati. Okay, Lord says, this fellow is not, it's not his anyway. But anyway, he offered today, on this day he offered. Again, tomorrow again he comes and do the same Arati, Tana, Mana, Dhanu. See, this was already offered. How can you say again, this is yours? You already offered once. You cannot offer again, same thing again and again. I cannot give you same gift every day. Once you give a gift, that is gone. So, obviously nobody offers. So, he is only making a statement, Tanu, Manu, Dhanu, Sab Kuch Tera Hai. Only yours. But at the same time, he is not ready to give up. Giving up that ownership is by understanding that I don't really own anything. That's how Ashtavakra says, you cannot renounce anything because you don't own anything to renounce it. Like my renouncing the presidentship of the United States. Say, yes sir, you are not even a president. Oh, that's why I am renouncing. So I cannot renounce something which I am not. So I even the ownership itself, this body in itself is not mine because I am ready to leave. I didn't design this body. The body is gift given to me for transacting in the world. It is somebody else's. So I have to take care of the body as a trustee. And that should be my attitude towards the body, towards ownership of anything. So that understanding, for that I should have prepared my mind. So we'll do Sloka 17. Bhranti matram idam vishvam, bhranti matram idam vishvam, nakinchiditi nischayi, nakinchiditi nischayi, nirvasana spurti matre, nirvasana spurti matre, nakinchidiva shamyati, nakinchidiva shamyati. Together. Bhranti matram idam vishvam, na kinchiditi nischayi, nirvasana spurti matre, na kinchidiva shamyati. So, bhranti matram idam vishvam, this whole world is just imagination. Imagination where? So, I thought this is the real. So, it is like a dream, where I am going to dream world, where the dream subject, once I created a dream world, I enter into my own dream creation as a jiva, an individual, looking at the world that is I myself created, and forgetting that I myself created, I consider myself only a local jiva, and transacting in the dream world, and I see a tiger is chasing me, and I am running to save myself. I created the tiger, I created the forest, I created jiva there also, and I am running from the tiger. Swami used to say, I was dreaming an examination, and where I created the questionnaire, I created the examination, and I was the investigator, invigilator, and I was sitting in the examination hall trying to answer the question that I myself created. And I flunked in that exam, my own exam. So this is the nature of this creation. I forget I am the one who created it. Because once I enter and forget my nature, take myself only, I am a jiva in the creation and the world is different from me. All that is only imagination. But as long as I am in the dream is not a dream for a dreamer in the dream. Only when he is awakened, he recognizes that it was only a dream and not real. Same way, the waking world is also real for the one who doesn't realize that he is the waker, which is supreme waker or conscious entity. And this waking is not going out of this state. It is in the waking state itself I can realize by using proper discriminative intellect. In the dream world, I cannot realize that it's a dream unless I wake up. But in the waking state, I can realize that it is a not real while in the waking state by using a discrimination. I do not have the discriminative capacity to do that in the dream, because nitya, anitya vastu viveka, that discriminative, what is real, what is not real, that in the dream state I do not have the intellect. Okay, if I have the intellect, I don't dream. I will be awake. So intellect goes down and dream is only a bhogabhumi, only exhaustive mechanism. I don't accumulate new vasanas there. Whereas in this world, I have an intellect, therefore I have I can accumulate new vasanas also. Here, bhranti matram idam vishvam, this entire universe that I see, idam, is only imagination in my mind. Because my mind is folded, there is no more bhranti, at least folded bhranti. So I am in the deep sleep state, there is no world. Only when the mind comes, the imaginations come, as I am a subject and this is an object, duality comes. So bhanti matram idam vishvam na kinchiditi nischayi. There is nothing reality to whatever to this. That's what the Vedanta says. The reality is that which does not undergo any change. That's the definition of real. And the whatever experience cannot be real because I am experiencing, because experience is different from experience. So according to Advaita Vedanta, it's not real because you experience. Whereas according to Visishta Advaita and Advaita, it's real because you experience. Same statement put in a different way. Because I am experience, it is not real, because whatever experience is different from experiencer and experiencing, and experience keep changing, therefore it's not real. Whereas for them, even though it is changing, it is still real. But even for them also, the changing necklace, bangle, necklace, they are real. But what about the gold? The ontological status, that means the reality, degree of reality is different from a gold and the ring. That they will not recognize it. Whereas Advaita recognizes and uses that. In fact, Vedanta recognizes and refines, says, Vacharambanam Vikaro Namadeyam. All the ornaments are nothing but Namke Vaste, only namesake ornaments. What is there is only gold. That's what we discussed in the earlier sloka. So, Nakinchideti, there is no reality to anything that I see. So, Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma, everything is nothing but Brahman. Nehan Anasti Kinchana, there is no varieties here actually in truth. So, Nirvasanaha Spurti Matre. So, the desirelessness is Spurti Matre, intelligence itself. That is the pure intelligence, recognizing that I don't need anything for me to be happy because I have understood that I am the full and happy state that I am. So I am no more longing for something, and as I am full. That has to be recognized. That is nirvasanaha spurti matre, by proper understanding. Nakinchidivya shamyati, that there is nothing really exists in this world for me to long for, to ask for or desire for.
Asidasti bhavishyati nate bandhosti mokshova, nate bandhosti mokshova, krutakrutyaha sukam chara.
Together,
eka eva bhavam bodham. Asidasti bhavishyati nati bandhosti mokshava, Kruta Pruchaha Sukham Chara. Eka Eva, there is only one. Eka Meva Advitiyam Brahma. So that is essentially Sadeva Saumya Vidamagram Asid Eka Meva Advitiyam. It is only one without a second. That is pure existence. And pure existence is of the nature of consciousness. It is Sat, Chit, and therefore Ananda, because there is nothing other than, which is therefore it is infinite. And infinite is Brahman, therefore it is the happiness state also. Limitless is a happy state. And Bhavambodam. So in this ocean of this, the existence, Asit, Vas, Asti, is, Bhavishyati, will be, Nate, Bandhosti. So in this ocean of this, ocean, there is a past, present and future. The whole time concept itself is an imagination. And you think that time is real and time and space are related by theory of relativity, because space is nothing but movement in time. I am here and when I go there, so there is a space in that I have traveled in the time wise. So the space is required to define time, time is required to define space. That's what the relativity is. So as is neither present nor the past nor the future is there. So time itself is an imaginary. Why? Because the present alone is there. Past is gone and future hasn't come. What is real is only present. But even that present is where past is meeting the future. So how gap is that present? So today is a present. This hour is a present, this minute is a present, this second is a present, and this microsecond is a present. I can keep on doing. The picosecond is present, and ultimately I can't even see, you want to divide it. But what is there really is the one who is doing division is independent of the time. So he alone is real, that is my presence alone is real. My presence is what? I am a conscious entity, existent entity, that alone is real. Even the time has disappeared. Past is not there, future has no basis, and present is where the past and future are meeting, and the gap itself becomes insignificant. And that is the real value of the time. So there is no past, present and future. Bhuta bhavya bhavat prabhu. So the one who is dividing independent of the past, present and future, and that is what Vishnu Sahasranama says, is essentially the Lord Vishnu who pervades everything. Nade bandhosti moksha. There is neither bondage nor liberation. Only if I think bondage is there, then I have to think of moksha, liberation. When there is no bondage, what is the point in liberation? Bondage is only a notion that I am only this. But when I recognize that I am not this, but I am Brahmasmi, then there is no moksha or bondage also. So, nati bandhosti mokshava krutakrutchaha. One who recognizes that I am totality, I am Brahmasmi, is fulfilled, because krutakrutchaha, mission accomplished. That means there is nothing to gain, because he understood that there is nothing to gain. He has gained what need to be gained. Krutakrutchaha. What to be gained? Recognition that there is nothing to be gained. I am full as I am. That is krutakrutchaha. And therefore, sukham chara. I cannot but be happy, because happiness is becomes my own nature. That's essentially the Ashtavakra tries to wrap up the teaching in the way that you are complete by yourself. There is no liberation, there is no the bondage, because you are already free. So even when you thought that you are not free, you are free only. It's only what is needed is recognition. That means recognition. That means reanalysis is required to realize that I am already full. Sloka 19 now. Ma sankalpa vikalpa abhyam. Ma sankalpa vikalpa abhyam. Chittam shobaya chinmaya. Chittam shobaya chinmaya. Upashamya sukham tishtai. Upashamya sukham tishtam. Swatmanyananda vigrahe. Swatmanyananda vigrahe. Together. Ma sankalpa vikalpa abhyam. Chittam shobaya chinmaya.
upasamya sukham tishtha swatmanyananda vigrahe. Ma sankalpa vikalpa bhyam. Do not by sankalpa vikalpa, that is by affirming and negating and all that, are there is no need all that. I am not this, I am not this, this negation of this, and then again I am this also. Even the so-called negation is only who am I? People say you are not this, you are not this, you are not this. You are becoming a smaller and smaller by neglecting. I am not the world, so I become. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. Then I become my nature is becoming limited. And how can I become infinite? Even the world is also I am. For that only Vedanta Vichara is required. That's not just who am I inquiry. And that's what people think reading the Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi's who am I inquiry is required. But who am I inquiry only provides you the Tvam Padartha Vichara. You need a Tat Padartha Vichara, and also to equate you are that also, what you rejected, I am not that. That also you are, but only rejection of superficial names and forms that you are rejecting. So, ma sankalpa vikalpa abhyam, neither affirming or denying anything. Chittam mind, kshobhaya disturbance by rajasic or regrets of the past. So, chinmaya, all pure consciousness you are, chitta kshobhaya chinmaya, chitta kshobhaya ma, don't get involved in I am not this, I am not this. That is preliminarily required in order to arrive at who you are. But when you arrive at who you are, you include everything as I am the totality that pervades the whole plurality. That is the real understanding. And then there is no more kshobhaya. That means no more perturbations in the mind, in the chittam. You are chinmayam. You are all pervading pure consciousness that is infinite. Upasamya sukham tishtha. So upasamya, so silencing everything else, sukham tishtha, abide in your own state, which is full state, where sukham anandas is your intrinsic nature. Being infinite, you cannot but be happy, because fullness is what is the symbolism of I am full. That means there is nothing more I want. And that's what is prajahati yadasamyan, yadasam prajahati atmani eva atmanatushtaha. So one who is reveling in himself by himself, because the self that he revels is a happy state. That's why atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. Only for my sake I need everything else, because I am full as I am. So swatmanyananda vigrahe. So swatmai ananda vigrahe, you are of the nature of pure ananda vigraham. That means pure happy state, and swatmam, that you revel in your own self. Atmani eva atmanatushtaha. That's what is Krishna calls it sita prajnaha. One who abides in himself, he has no more longing for anything, because he is full. Why is full? Because I am a Brahman. I am infinite. So there is nothing else you can add to that. I may play the drama of life, but I am as I am, whether I play or not, yogartova, bhogartova, sangartova, sangavihinaha. Either I am playing this game here, or sitting in Himalayas and playing there, or going here, going in the company, all that is drama of life. Whatever the prarabdha dictates, that's what he will do. But knowing very well, all this only drama, I am an actor playing the roles only. Roles will have a problem, but I have no problem. I have the happy as I am. That should be recognition. The last sloka of this chapter. Chajaiva dhyanam sarvatra. Chajaiva dhyanam sarvatra. Ma kanchit hrudi dharaya. Ma kinchit hrudi dharaya. Atma tvam muktaye vasi. Atma tvam muktaye vasi. Vimushya evasi. Kim vimushya karishyasi. Kim rumushya karishyasi. Together. Chajaiva dhyanam sarvatra. Ma kinchit rudidharaya. Atma tvam muktaye vasi. Kim vimushya karishyasi. So, chaja, give up Eva dhyanam, this meditation. I want to do meditation. What for? On whom are you going to meditate?
Aham jata param jeyam akhandam khandate katham.
So in the Advaita Gita, Dattatre says, you want to meditate on what?
You are trying to say, I am meditating on this. Where you are trying to divide a meditator and meditated and meditation, where there is no divisions possible.
So this, even the notion that I have to meditate in order to realize, I am already that, what is there to meditate on?
So a jnani doesn't have to meditate because he is in the meditative state only.
So, chajiva dhyanam sarvatra. So, in every way give up the notion that I have to meditate. Ma kinchit hrudidharaya.
So, do not hold anything in your heart or in your mind as I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to do this, I need to do that.
All that is only confused mind, not realizing you are already full and you cannot do anything also.
Any doing is only a drama. You can play a drama, but knowing very well you are playing the drama, and the problems of the role belongs to the roles and not to you.
That's what essentially. Ma kinchit hrudi dharaya.
Atma tvam mukta eva.
See. So atma tvam, you are indeed the self ever free. You are already free. There is no point of seeking freedom. The very seeking freedom denies your freedom.
So I had to recognize that I am free. That's what is to be meditated on.
So meditation is not to gain freedom. Meditation is to recognize that I am already free and there is nothing to gain.
And same way, Vedanta Sravanam is required to know that there is nothing to do any Vedanta Sravana because you are already that.
Once you realize that, until then you need to do it.
So one has to be careful here.
So Atma Atma Mukta Eva see. Kim Vimurshya Karishyasi.
So Kim Vimurshya Karishyasi, what meditation will do?
So therefore there is no meditation, meditated is the sadhana, all that. But remember this story, I had to run 4 miles to discover that I don't need to run 4 miles. Because I have a chain my wife gave me, and I went 4 miles, I went to show the chain to my friend, and after seeing, then after chit-chatting for another half an hour, I came back home and discovered that I'm missing my chain. And I thinking that my wife will be coming, I want to get back, I ran back to my friend 4 miles to ask, where is my chain, do I left it? So I said, no, you didn't leave it here, and searched, ultimately found that the chain was in my neck only, it was folded and I couldn't see.
So the question is, was that 4 miles running necessary to discover the missing chain?
So if I say yes, it is required, then so no, I never lost it for me to run.
Or if I say it's not needed, no, I need to run because I thought I lost it and I would not know, I'll be unhappy.
So the correct answer is 4 miles of running is necessary to discover that 4 miles of running is not necessary.
Same way, all sadhanas are necessary. Vedanta Sravana is required to discover that there is no need of Vedanta even.
Provided I have gone through, discovered my true nature.
And this is the nature of the teaching that Ashtavakra gives in this.
We'll go into the how to abide in the self in the next talk.
With this, we finish the chapter 15.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamiva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.